Whereas Parliament passed into law the National Content Bill 2019, President Yoweri Museveni declined to assent to the bill and returned it to Parliament for reconsideration before it was shelved.
That one is clear that countries like Kenya, Tanzania, South Sudan, Rwanda are not really looking at us as brothers and sisters. However, I support the president on this.
The bill has since been passed twice by the 10th Parliament, but only to be returned by the president. In his latest communication to the Speaker of Parliament, the president noted that it was not proper for Uganda to make a law protecting the domestic market, yet it's opening up to the East African community market.
His thinking is really positive, because he's one of those people I've been advocating for a federation of East Africa, for us as East Africans to have better economies.
I desired that we have joint ventures, that companies that come to work here in this country come work with Ugandan companies for every project that is being implemented. Thirdly, I desired that Ugandans are given priority when they are giving out smaller contracts.
Kasanda North MP Patrick Oshabe Nsamba is concerned that most of the road projects constructed on taxpayers' money and loans and contracts are gifted to foreign contractors. These include the 1.7 trillion shilling Kampala Entebbe Expressway loan from Exim Bank China, gifted to China Communications Construction Company, the Hoima Kaiso Tonya Road using funds from the government at a cost of 360 billion shillings that went to the Turkish firm Colin Construction Company, as well as the Kanoni Sembabule Villa Maria Road at a price of 239.12 billion shillings. That was given to China Railway Engineering Group, which leaves Ugandans with no business.
Why do you think that it is only Chinese, it's only that foreigners that can do things, yet you can support the Ugandans here? This law, the local content law, is intended to make sure that Ugandans, it's an affirmative action law which ensures that Ugandans are not left behind. We will not stop demanding that Ugandans are part and parcel of the development process in this country.
Nsamba says the Buy Uganda, Build Uganda policy, which seeks to increase consumption and utilization of local products and increase participation of locally established firms in domestic trade, is simply lip service.
They sing it, but at the end of the day when they're buying, they buy as government, they buy foreign products. They are telling Ugandans to buy just to please the people who are here, the investors, but they themselves as government, they don't want to buy Uganda. So it's just a campaign they are doing, and they are not committed to it at all.
The Kasanda North lawmaker and other MPs now want Parliament to pass this bill for the third time without changing a word, and it becomes a law without the president's assent, since he has bounced it two times. MPs argue that it will be a blunder for Uganda to make a law that opens up its market from other players in the region while other partner states are not ready.
There should be harmonization between the parliament and the executive. Oftentimes these bills are referred back to the NRM caucus, where the president might well go and address the caucus so that they understand his position. But the tradition is that the practice is that if the bill is referred twice and parliament doesn't change it, it becomes law.
And if you follow the law, once a law, if the president failed to assent to it twice, the third time it comes before parliament, it passes as a law. Law is law.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.